What's going on, everybody? It's Scott Phoenix. And last week, I had the awesome opportunity to speak with General Manager Alejandro Perez from Rocky Mountain Cannabis here in Fraser, Colorado. And he's cooking up something major. His new platform, CannaQuest, is sure to change the way a lot of people think about marijuana that right now don't like it. Okay? He's offering a safe, okay? He's offering a easy to use and a generational non-biased product, right? And that's what we need right now. So I sat down with him and we talked about business in general, and I think we're gonna work very well together. Matter of fact, we're gonna be bringing him his show, CannaQuest, starting this weekend. So make sure you're watching on his platform for that, because that's gonna be hot. So without further ado, I'd like to present to you episode one of Making a Millionaire, CannaQuest.
You good, T-Minus?
Niggas been counting me out. I'm counting my bullets. I'm loading my clips. I'm writing down names. I'm making a list. I'm checking it twice and I'm getting them hit. The real ones been dying. The fake ones is lit. The
game
is
off balance.
I'm back on my shit. The Bentley is dirty. My sneakers is dirty. But that's how I like it. You all on my dick. I'm all in my bag. That's hard as it get.
I think that there's a lot of spontaneous talk going on. But why don't we just handle the nitty gritty of the intros? And you can go ahead and introduce yourself and, you know, what you do for work.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Cool. So my name is Alejandro. Should I look at you or
camera?
All right. Cool. So my name is Alejandro. Alejandro Perez. I started off as a bud tender in Colorado, but now I'm actually the general manager for Rocky Mountain Cannabis in Fraser. Aside from that, I'm been like self-educating myself, you know, so much research going into cannabis history, cannabis science, and I want to translate that over to the general public, you know, I want to make consumer-friendly information out there. So I started Canna Questions, which is just my Instagram for now, working on a website, you know. I've also trying to market myself as a cannabis consultant. I'd like to go around to different dispensaries and, you know, help train their bud tending staff.
Absolutely.
Because, like, I don't know if you've been to a lot of dispensaries, but I've been to a lot of different dispensaries. And when I go in, you know, I actually take a little book with me and I kind of like write down like what I notice about my experience there.
Yes.
You know, and a lot of the times when I first walk into a dispensary, the bud tender that greets me, you know, at the counter or whatever, or their desk, you know, they're not too receptive to you.
Right.
You know, sometimes they seem like maybe they're too high, or that maybe they haven't like worked in customer service.
Or almost standoffish.
Yeah, or really standoffish. You know? Like they got like this attitude, and I feel like that turns a lot of people off of cannabis.
You know, a lot of people that are buying weed used to buy it on the black market, you know, and there's that nostalgic feeling of going to the weed dealer, you know, and like, people want that.
You know how many times we get a customer that comes in and says like, oh, I smoked this one strain back in 1985 and, you know, got me so baked with my friends, you know, do you have something like that? So, like one of the main problems is like you'll talk to a bartender and like your experience stops at, do you like indica or sativa?
Right.
You know, but there's so much more to
like
that.
What kind of indica and sativa. And that's like, and with the you know, the progression of the industry is that's what the general information needs to be. You know, everybody knows indica and sativa right now. People want something more, and I think that that's what you're trying to offer.
Yeah.
You know.
Like, I could really blow someone's mind, and I, you know, and like, I'll look at a customer and I'll be like, you know, did you know that indica and sativa doesn't really matter anymore? Everything is a hybrid. You know, you could have an indica, and that indica could be bred from three different indica strains. You know?
Right.
But what indica and sativa are really just talking about is just like the structure of the plant. You know?
Right. You know? Right. And I can tell you that, especially in Denver, and I'm sure that you understand this, like everybody that works at these dispensaries, I feel like, isn't from Colorado. You know, and like, they like came out here for that experience.
It's the new gold rush. They called it the green rush. You know, like when Colorado first started going recreational, we actually saw like this massive migration of people coming from, you know, just all around the country just to have access to it. Yeah.
You know, and would you say that more of your customers are looking for like a medical or more a recreational?
It's there's definitely a difference. Some are just looking for recreational, and I don't think that there's anything wrong with just wanting to smoke to get high. I mean, that's kind of what we're doing right now.
Absolutely.
We're just looking just to get high and have a good conversation.
Absolutely.
You know, and then there's the people who are coming over because they need it. Mm-hmm. You know, like I was watching a documentary, and it was this family from Texas, like a family of three, and one of their children were very ill. Mm-hmm. They left their whole entire life in Texas.
Right. I think I've heard of
they
that.
They had like a big house. They had a nice careers going. They left everything to come to Colorado.
Because they could give the seizure mitigation from whatever you were taught.
They say that racism is learned, not, you know.
Absolutely. Yeah, yeah.
Genetic.
That's absolutely true. Yeah. It is learned, and it's given by misinformation, mm-hmm. you know, and yeah. fear.
Exactly.
You know, and that's.
Just like him. It's like, you know, yeah. I had written like a really short article for Sky High News. Just like an opinion piece, uh-huh. you know, one of those opinion pieces that they put out.
Right.
And it was about how we need to end the stigma, you know.
Right.
And it was about that. It was about how everybody sees cannabis the way they see, most people see cannabis the way they see it because it's just a learned fear,
mm-hmm.
you know. It's a learned stigma. It's like,
right. Still think we're just a bunch of dumb hippies? Alejandro is definitely doing some big things, and he agreed to let us follow him around for the next extended amount of time, and I'm also gonna help him out with some marketing and, of course, the production of the CannaQuest TV show, which is actually gonna start this Sunday. So make sure that you check it out. You can see a copy of that here, but it's not gonna be the full version, because the full version is gonna be with Alejandro, and you wanna check him out on Instagram. All of the pertinent links will be in the description. And thank you for being a part of history. This is the very first episode of Making a Millionaire. We'll see you next time when I meet with AJ Wicks from Pain and Pleasure Tattoo. Love yourself, love your family, and while you're at it, love everyone.
I just poured something in my cup. I've been wanting something.